Hello, my name is Steve. Thanks for stopping by my channel to check this video out. I'm going to show you how I made these cabinet doors using pallet wood and some 1x3 poplar for the stiles and the rails. Coming up next. All right, we got all the pallet wood resawed, so it's cut in half now. There's a lot of cutting. Hopefully what I'm getting ready to do to it next will make it work as planned. But it's about 100 pieces sitting there. There's a piece here. This is one side of the pallet wood. The other side. Open it up. All right, next step is to run them through the planer, and then hopefully we'll get them to the same thickness, all of them, so we can put them into the cabinet doors.
Thank you. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do is mark the position where I want the center of the hole. And I'm just using the same dimensions from the existing cabinet doors, which is 4 1/4 inches. I have these original hinges made by Grass, which I'm using. It's the same hole diameter as the Craig jig. The only difference is it doesn't get the hole close enough to the edge here. It's 3 millimeters, I guess, is the closest I can get. So I gotta change that. I put these two spacers, pieces of metal, which actually gets it to the location I need. So there's a little centering indent on this gauge here. Line it up with the mark where you want the center of the hole, and it'll end up being right there. So I just set my shims in there. Line up the indent of the Craig jig to the center mark for the hole. Clamp it in place, making sure it's tight against the edge of the wood. Insert the Craig drill bit holder into the jig and then drill a hole. Repeat the process for the next hole. Just line it up with your mark wherever you want it. Clamp it in place. Insert the drill bit guide. Drill your hole. That out. Now we have two holes evenly spaced where I need them. Now I take the original hinge, line it up where I need it, use a clamp to clamp that down, make sure it's straight, and I have a self-centering drill bit that guides the hole, because the Craig jig has a couple guide holes in it, but they don't line up to these style hinges because they're so old, I guess. So they're from the 80s. So newer hinges they'll work fine on, but not these old ones. Pallet holes. Same process. Straightened up. I like to clamp it down so it doesn't move on me. And that is it. Okay. Got the frame of the door. The the rabbet cut out of it. We got some the pieces of pallet wood that we cut in half. Decided to go with the rough finish on the outside, which we've sanded down already. So just make sure we have enough to cover the rabbet from each side. And then I just kind of get the wood set in where I want it so I can start squaring it up. I like this knot, so I want to keep that knot in there. I don't want it to be in the center. So I'll trim a little off this board, a little off this board. I cut that here and there. Here I'll get rid of this, everything from this dark spot. Get rid of that. And on this one, it's looking pretty good too. Kind of like that. Trim that right there. So I'm just going to trim these off and be right back. And that's one side cut now. Now we'll get a measurement. This is. I'll leave a little bit of a gap going around the inside of the rabbet. So I'm going to go with 13 inches. That's going to leave me about a 32nd of an inch all the way around on these two sides. So we're going to cut these 13 inches wide. Make sure they're all pressed against the fence. Try to keep them as straight as we can. Make sure the edges are straight. That fresh edge we got there, straight. Cut these a little bit longer. That with the X to cut that side off and cut this side off. So these two, like that. Alright, so now we're going to center these just by eyeing it up first. I have the X's marked where we're going to cut off. So now we'll just find the a happy medium here. Looks like it might be 4 11/16. So as you can see, 4 11/16 just fits in there, a little bit of wiggle room. So now we need to round off the corners. So to do that, we flip these over. Everything just lines up. Make sure things line up better. I'm gonna just, I got a socket that matches the radius of that inside rabbet. I'm just gonna mark these two edges here. That one. That one, this one here. I'm just going to sand that off. It's just a small radius on both of those. So now we'll sand those two off and see how they fit. Dust collection. Here we go. Alright, here's the first one we cut. See how that fits in there nicely. Alright, fits in there pretty good. That's what that looks like. Prior to any paint or stain, so looks pretty nice. Clean up the edges here a little bit with the paint. Paint run over on the edge. There's a train. Don't even hear them after a while. You get so used to them. test fit it first. Make sure there's no real sometimes it's good. Clear finish kind of runs over. It's a little it's going very light. Very light pass on that to try to clean that up a little bit. Centering it up a little bit, and tack it in place. So that, get a little closer here. See, this one has a little bit of a bow to it, so that's why we kind of keep the nails, staples on the inside. I gotta go the other way. Gotta go the other way so I can angle it back in a little bit. See what that looks like. Okay, here's another one. Dry fit the outside better, I think. Hard to say. We left one side kind of rough and one side kind of flat, so kind of put the rough side on the outside and kind of hope for the best. So, turn it this way, maybe you can see a little better with the angle I do. Kind of hold it at an angle to shoot back into the frame, so that hopefully the nail staple doesn't kick out the side. Uh-oh. I like that one. Wood intake, stay in the centered angle back, helps push that down, it is pallet wood, so it's not the flattest wood, but that's the look we're going for, so. All in all, it's turning out pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it so far. Another one back hinge locations, flip it over, hopefully your staples come through, good to go.